Hey everybody, what's going on? Your host, Lovely Cheese Pizza here. Welcome to another edition of Sports Sunday, where we talk about sports, life, and everything in between. And oh my god, do I have one of the ultimate versions of everything in between for you guys tonight. I had told you in a previous episode that I was going to tell you about this particularly amazing set of memorabilia that I came up on, and I am going to deliver because I finally got through both of them today. And we're going to be displaying pictures throughout the course of this, so just prepare for that. But oh my god, this is so awesome. So we're going to take on the SNK Crushers for the fourth time here. Just in case that this game goes by really quickly, I may just start up a second game on top of it, because there's a lot to talk about here, so I want to try to get through all of it. So we'll see what happens. So let's talk about this wonderful piece of hilariously bad excellence here. I'll try, and I apologize if some of my pictures don't coincide with what I'm talking about. Like if I do it out of order, I'm gonna try to do my best with it. But if I mess up, I apologize. Or if I forget to mention something and it's just up on the screen, you'll just have to go with it. But so here's the story. So last week I went to this little comic book shop with a couple friends of mine, just downtown here where I'm at, and I had never been there before, and so I finally got to go in there, and I was gonna check out, you know, their wares and whatnot. And it was a really cool little place too. Like, it wasn't very big, but there was actually surprisingly a lot more than I thought there would be in there. And so we're checking out all these different comics. They just have bins, just like boxes filled to the brim with comics and whatnot in there. And so I'm looking, there's like Deadpool comics in there, and there's like the Teen Titans, and there's Incredible Hulk, and there's Iron Man, and there was even this one, it was like this weird special edition Deadpool one, but it was Winnie the Pooh. I'll even put the picture up. It was Winnie the Pooh, but it was Winnie the Pooh disguised as Deadpool, and it was called Deadpool. It was so stupid, but really funny at the same time. It was like one of the best parody looking things I think I've ever seen. And it was like $75, I think. Like, it was a pretty expensive comic. So obviously they didn't make very many of them, would be my guess. But anywho, so I'm going through all these bins. Wow, he is out. Oh, maybe not. So I'm looking through these bins, and I go to the end spot, and I'm not even kidding you. I'm not kidding when I say that this is legitimately what I saw. I pulled out these two comics, and keep in mind, these are Marvel comics. This is on Stan Lee's hands, man. Oh my god, it's so funny. I found in this bin the adventures of NFL Super Pro. It was an actual comic series that was made, and I did some research on it. And apparently, in the early 90s, Marvel and the NFL kind of decided to have this little joint adventure, which definitely joints were involved, because I feel like they had to have been high to have agreed to this thing. But they decided to try and capture the audience of you know, comic book viewers, and they thought it'd be a cool idea to see if they could capitalize on that. It was an untapped market for sports at the time, really. There wasn't really a lot of that going on. And so they thought they'd give it a go. And let's just say that it did not pan out very well. there were only 12 issues, or volumes, I don't know what the correct terminology is there. There were 12 different comics over the course of like 1 year, and then that was the end of it. They never renewed it for, they just decided not to go any further because it bombed really bad. And it is now known, like, apparently, in the world of comic bookery, that not only is it considered like the worst Marvel comic series of all time, but in some circles it's actually considered to be like one of the worst comic series total. And that like, I read through both of them today for the first time, and I'm definitely not going to say that they're good, because there are just incredible amounts of cheesy ass lines in there, but I'm pretty sure that there's worse comics out there. For Marvel, I can see why this is a giant stain, just a giant shit stain in the underwear of their legacy. But oh my god, it's actually not that bad. There's definitely a couple of moments where I got some legitimate good hearty laughs out of it. Now, it was at it's negative expense, but, and like, but like the art style was pretty good. So I mean, it's not like it was really poorly drawn or anything. I mean, you guys will get to see pictures of it in a minute. And like, there are definitely some flaws in the storyline and whatnot, and like the design of NFL Super Pro in general, is pretty ridiculous. He looks like, he looks like a really bad knockoff version of Captain America if they were to rebrand everything he was wearing into NFL gear. Just take a look at these. the second comic cover is the best one though, with the character Quick Kick in there. That is definitely a home run. Yikes. Boy, that was a bomb. But yeah, Quick Kick. That's the best one. When Quick Kick is on offense, there is no defense. That is fantastic. So, I decided to take the liberty of writing down a bunch of quotes from this, especially the first comic had the most of it. But the storyline, I'll explain the storyline a little bit so I don't have to keep, you know, going back and forth with it. But essentially, the storyline is very Superman-like. It follows the adventures of a guy named Philip Grayfield. He's an investigative sports journalist that, you know, he investigates different sports-related things. Like, in the first comic, he was investigating an illegal, you know, anabolic steroids drug ring, and in the second one, he was investigating, like gang activity. And so, it's kind of like one of those sorts of things, trying to, you know, capture the NFL fans' interest while also promoting awareness of these things for kids. You know, one of those types of things. But, And so this guy that's the investigative journalist is also NFL Super Pro, and he became that, he was an all-pro, actually I'll explain that part in a minute here. So it starts out with these guys at like a, in like a warehouse in the middle of the night, and they're unloading a truck, and these guys are talking to each other like, what do you think's in these boxes, and one guy's like, you know, could be some type of chemical mess and blow up in our faces. And then Super Pro just appears out of nowhere and he's like, I'd recommend you worry about something else blowing up in your face, like my fist. It's such a cheap line. That is such a cheap line. And then I think he ends up like beating them all up after that. And so, they turn and look and they're like, who does this guy think he is? Super Football Man? And his response is, close, Einstein, but you missed the first down marker by the length of a chain. That is such a stupid line, but perfectly amazing at the same time. It's so well placed. It's so dumb, though. And so I think that's the moment where he goes and beats him up. That is the most humiliating way to be thrown out at first, by the way. And so then, you know, they get turned over to the police or whatever, and the police are talking to him, and they're asking him, you know, like, what are you doing here? Like, you know, who are you? What are the... And so he decides to come up with this little gem of a line. He's like, I've been on the trail of an illegal steroid production ring, but this little play from scrimmage didn't gain me much yardage, so arrivederci. And then he just leaves. He just, like, leaves on that little note there. It's so dumb. Oh, but it's great at the same time. It is amazing. The people that wrote the dialogue for that are just marvels of modern humanity, or 90s humanity, I suppose. So after that, he's got to go meet up with his girlfriend, who just so happens to be a news reporter for the local channel that he also works at. And so, before he gets out of the car, or when he's, like, on his way walking in, he's, like, 35 minutes late for this little date of theirs. And, right before he walks in, he's having, like, this little inner monologue with himself, and he's like, she's gonna give me one of her patented, you're late and I should have had dinner with the fifth guy that asked me out stairs. It's mad funny. Because, I mean, how many guys haven't had that thought before? That was one of those types of things. And so, they're talking, blah, 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 blah. She's asking him, you know, what the story is, and he's like, you're just gonna have to wait, and all this stuff. And so, then it comes out a little bit later that, you know, about what the whole thing with the steroids are. They find out that there's, like, a rookie player, like, a rookie football player from, for the Chicago Bears that in the offseason of, you know, from college to now, he is massively gained in size, and so they thought maybe he was juicing, because that was kind of a pandemic around the league at that time, and so they thought, you know, maybe it'd be a good idea if we if we maybe tried to expose this a little bit. That's the second time I've done that on accident. Directional pad's kind of weird here. I'm getting a little bit too trigger-happy here. So they're talking about it, and so Super Pro and his assistant, I can't remember what his name is offhand, they're talking about how they're gonna try to find a way to expose it and see if maybe there's like a, maybe there's something to it, because they saw this player getting delivered his steroids by this guy, and so they follow the guy and find out he's a professor at like the local college, and so they decide, Philip Grayfield decides that he's going to go investigate on this, and while he goes and investigates, his partner ends up investigating him in the process and finds out later that he's Super Pro and questions him about it and all this stuff. And so then he decides to get the whole backstory. He gets the entire backstory of how he became what he is, and the story for it is actually fairly intriguing, actually. So Philip Grayfield, when he was a young lad, he was an all pro football player, all pro linebacker for 3 years at Notre Dame, and he was like one of the best players that anyone had ever seen in decades, and he went number one overall and to the Philadelphia Eagles, and he was gonna be the one. You know, Buddy Ryan said he's gonna be the one that's gonna, you know, help take me to, you know, that we're gonna go to the Super Bowl and win the whole thing and restore order in our franchise and all this stuff. And on the first day, his first day at practice, he tore his ACL. And then, so he does the rehab, and he gets better, and he comes back, and he's ready to play, and in his first exhibition game, he breaks his leg. And so, then he gets cut by the team, and he rehabs, and he's at a practice with his new team that he's with, and makes a friend with the starting quarterback, and they're talking one day, and he's like there with the guy's son, and the son's running up the bleachers, and he trips and falls off, and he tries to jump in and save the kid, and in the process ends up breaking his leg again, and that ended his career. And so that's when he took up the whole journalism thing. And so in the process of this, he ends up getting this interview with this guy. He's like a shady figure. He's got like all of this like stolen merchandise and all this memorabilia and all this stuff. And so he decides to go and investigate him, and the guy actually agreed to talk to him and whatnot. And so he goes in there and he's looking at all the memorabilia and all this stuff, and he's asking him all these questions, and then he finds out that the guy not only, you know, massively collected sports memorabilia, but he also was an inventor by trade and had invented the NFL Super Pro suits, which were basically, like, super advanced, just like regular, like the regular uniforms for the NFL, and what he had intended for them to be was like the new, he wanted them to be the new official uniforms of the NFL. And, like, they'd be personally fitted to every person because of the material they were made out of and whatnot, and they were supposed to be safer and all this stuff. But because of the expense of it, it would have cost millions of dollars per jersey, and so it would have never worked, and so he only made the one prototype. And so, while they're there talking in the laboratory, these guys break into the warehouse, and you don't even know I don't remember who they even were, but they decide that they're gonna kidnap the guy who owned the place, and they end up tying up Grayfield in some old game tape, and instead of stealing all the memorabilia, they just decide that they're gonna burn the entire place down for some reason. That's one of the big plot holes, is like, why would they do that and destroy all this priceless stuff instead of just taking it and then selling it for a lot of money? They just decide that they're gonna burn this guy alive in here, and that's gonna be the end of it. And so they tie him up, and then they light the place on fire, and so, you know, now, and then he like ends up tipping over like this container of the, like this liquid alloy stuff or whatever, and he gets coated in it, and he's like burning, and then he, for some reason, somehow gets inside of the Super Pro suit, and then he turns into like the superhero guy. Like, it's a very unorthodox way for that to be the genesis of the hero, because like the suits themselves they weren't designed to like improve your strength or your skills or any of that stuff. It just, they were just supposed to be better overall jerseys, And somehow he turned into a superhero over it. Even in the dialogue, he's like, I don't even know what happened. I put it on, and that's pretty much what it was. It's this really weird thing. And so now he finds out that he's the guy, instead of telling everybody who he is, his partner, he just decides that he's gonna help out, restore justice to the League and try to foil anybody who would compromise the integrity of it and all this stuff. And so they end up doing that, and so he decides that he now is going to go try to find evidence to link the rookie player and the professor or scientist guy together. And so he goes and tries to break into the warehouse where they're producing all this stuff, and he jumps over the fence, and then he's like, "Now, to avoid any guards and get inside, smoother than AstroTurf. They make it look so easy on TV. And it is! to escape the guards or whatever. Such a cheap... He's such an arrogant douche. But at the same time, he's just like... He's like the perfect guy for this. It's really funny. And so, he goes in there and he ends up... He can't find anything specifically to link them together. And later on, they do get the evidence to link them together. And so, they finally went and talked to him and they got him to break down and talk about it. And so they... When they're questioning him, he lets them know that in just a matter of time, the player's going to take his final dose of the steroid, and that's going to be like the one that's going to give him the big significant jump in his abilities and whatnot. So, and then it kind of flashes over to when the guy actually does it, and he takes his last dose, and the whole thing just goes insane from there. Like, the guy, mutates into, this weird, incredible Hulk-looking guy, but with more, boils on his skin. Uh-oh. It basically looks like a prepubescent, not green Incredible Hulk guy. And so then the guy goes on a freaking rampage and he's going insane because his body doesn't know how to handle that level of steroids. And so then, Super Pro comes up, but right before he goes out there while he's changing into his thing, his partner's like, dude, you better be on it. He's like, you better be on it, over it, and under it, in reference to, he needs to be, on top of his game to deal with this guy. And he's like, it's that bad, huh? He's like, I think he's eating a Buick right now. And the guy's just, totally raging out. And so then they end up fighting, and this is, the ultimate trying to drive in the whole... point of why steroids are a bad thing. They're fighting, the guy's getting stronger and stronger, and his rage is building, and so it finally comes down to it, and Super Pro's fighting him, and he's kicking his ass, and all of a sudden, the guy just totally wigs out, and he dies of a heart attack. The guy that's on the anabolic steroids, in the most NFL way possible, dies of a heart attack. And that's the end of it. They end up players from his team are like, what happened to Carl or whatever his name was? And they said that, he died of a heart attack, and that's just kind of the end of it. And they showed at the end, a couple of other rookie players were, they had some steroids on them in their locker, and they decided after hearing that they were gonna go flush them down the toilet. And they were never gonna do that again, and everything was gonna be good. And that was the end of that one. It was just so hilarious. Oh man, it was really bad though. It was hilariously bad. And the second one was definitely not anywhere near as entertaining. The second one was much more vanilla. The quality of it wasn't even as good. The first one, they had all the nice glossy pages and all of that. And the second one, the pages were made out of the same stuff they're printing newspapers with. The quality had such a big dip in it. And the dialogue wasn't anywhere near as interesting. The subject matter wasn't quite as good. But there were still a couple of good ones in there too, though. Namely, the title of the comic, the whole quick kick, when quick kick is on offense, there is no defense thing. But the best line from that one was these, it was like a flashback to the 80s when when Grayfield was still playing in college, and his girlfriend was watching the game with these two other reporter guys, I think it was, and oh, come on, get out of here, baby! Ah! Oh, yeah, there it is. I didn't know if they were going to call it foul or not. It was really close. I don't even know who hit that. Who actually hit that thing? Was that Snakes? It might have been Snakes. No, it wasn't. It was whoever it was. I can't remember who it was now. But yeah, so they're watching the game, and so they decide to talk to her, and they're like, hey, your boyfriend has some smooth moves. And she's like, her response is, smoothest move he makes is off the field. Like, totally implying, like, you know, sexually in the old plow room there. And so the other guy responds with, I'm sure. And she's like, I mean his 3.6 GPA. It's so dumb. It's such a stupid response. But at the same time, it's genius to, like, you know, put that part of it to bed. And then, like, later on in the comic, I don't remember who he was talking to. I think he was, like, talking to, like, some sort of gangster or something. And the guy, he was, like, talking and doing, like, his little I'm gonna bring justice thing or whatever. And the guy that he was talking to says, stuff it, tight end man. He called him tight end man. And he told him to stuff it. That's, like, the ultimate, like, cram it into your ass type of insult right there. It's funny. But yeah, that one was really depressing. The subject matter of that one, I'll just run it down real quick, because I didn't really take as many pictures for that one. But the guy, like, one of his teammates in college was a guy that Grayfield, like, always stole the thunder from this guy. Like, he thought that he was the best player, but Grayfield stole the thunder from him, so he decided to take up a life of being, like, a masked ninja football-playing vigilante or whatever, called Quick Kick. I don't know why, but that's the name he went with for some reason. And so he, you know, was... He worked for, like, the mob or something like that, and he was gonna go get this, shipment of, I think it was either drugs or it was guns. I think it was guns, actually. And so Super Pro ends up being the guy that intervenes on that towards the end of the comic, and he finds out that it was a guy that used to be his friend and his teammate and all this stuff. And he tries to reason with him, and they end up fighting, and the plane that had all the weapons, cash, and all that stuff in it, Super Pro accidentally knocks it off of its, you know, it, he, like, knocks it, and the plane starts rolling, and it's going towards the bay or whatever, and so Quick Kick goes towards the thing, and he intercepts the plane, and he's gonna try to fly it away, but there was a damaged wing on it, and Super Pro, like, tried to let him know. He's like, you're never gonna make it, you're not gonna be able to fly this thing to wherever you're trying to go, and he's just like, the guy wouldn't listen, and then the way the comic ends is he ends up crashing the plane into the bay, and he dies. It's two straight comics of the guy, like, the main antagonist of the whole thing just dying in, like, this terrible, grisly, bloody way. It's just so weird. I can see why it totally flopped in certain situations. You just can't have that. And, like, one of the quotes, too, was for Quick Kick, when he finally came up on all the guns or whatever before he loaded them into the plane. He like, beat up some guys to get to the stuff, and he, like, looks at the guns, and he's like, Lord, do I love to win or what? Bada bim, bada boom! And I'm like, who says that? Who would ever say that? Especially a guy that's dressed up as a ninja. Like, who would ever say that? Ever? Nobody, that's who. Just so bizarre, man. It's such an awesome addition to my collection of memorabilia in general, but such a weird, weird thing that exists in the Marvel Universe somehow. It's just one of the most strange. I want to really try to get the other 10 volumes of the comic, because I know they're out there. And so, I don't know how expensive they're going to be. I mean, I got those two comics for $3, so I can't imagine they'd be very expensive, but probably kind of hard to find. So, hopefully, if I can get all the rest of them, we'll talk about the rest of them on this show. But, oh man, these are so... Are they not totally ridiculous or what? It's so stupid. Oh, man. But it's, like, hilariously stupid. Like, when I read those, I got, like, a genuine laugh out of them. And that's, I mean, that's really what they're for. You know, it may not have been, like, a genuine, man, this stuff is awesome type of thing. Like, you know, I would read it over and over and over again. But I got, you know, especially in the first volume, I got a couple of legitimate, like, this is really funny because of how bad it is laugh, man. It was good. It was bad, but it was good though. It was definitely a laugh that I needed too. So that's what made it, you know, all the more important. We'll go with Prestige here. And then how about, I feel like we always go to Kevin for some reason. And maybe, well, maybe we should actually. Oh, nope, we can't. We're out of money already. We already ran out of money, really, from one player. Ugh. That's the one thing I hate about the SNK Crushers, man. They don't give you, like, any money for beating them. Alright, guys, well, I actually got it all out into one game here. I thought that we were going to blow them out again, and we still did, but it wasn't in the way that I had thought. So, when we come back on the next episode of Sports Sunday, we'll have more things to talk about. If I can get my hands on more of these Super Pro comics, we'll talk about more of it, because I think these things are great. And in the third episode, too, he's supposed to meet up with a villain called Instant Replay, who can actually, you know, phase in and out of time, apparently. He has the ability for time travel in small increments. That is a legitimate villain. Instant Replay. So, yeah, it's crazy, you guys. But until then, this has been your host, Lovely Cheese Pizza, saying thank you guys for watching, and don't do steroids. See you guys later. Bye.